I began preaching prophetess when I was 14 years old. Called to the ministry under a dynamic pastor at 14 years old, but she made me sit under her tutelage for 3 years and learn about the things of God, to learn how to serve rather than just grabbing a Bible and preaching. Then after, I'd say about the age of 19, when I went away to college, and on campus, it dawned on me that I did not know God.
Wow.
All of those years preaching, teaching, raising people to emotional hysteria, but I did not know God.
Wow.
I knew how to look holy. I knew how to act holy, but I did not know God. And as long as I was at home with mama and with grandmother and my pastor, there were people there saying to me, you can't do this, and you shouldn't do this, and you can't go there. But when I went away to college, there was nobody standing over me to tell me what I can and cannot do. So I fell into sin because there was no power of God in my life. My God. Had the gifts, but no power.
Now, when you say that, when you say you have the gifts, but no power, leading up to the time before you had your experience, what spiritually, and I really wanted to ask you this, and I've wanted to ask you this for some time, what was it that you began to feel when you found relationship? Because this is the point that I really want people to understand, that you can have a relationship with the Lord. You can have a time with God where you walk with God, you experience God, and then circumstances can cause you to begin to back away from the passion that you had toward the Lord. And I want you to talk about, because I know from college, and then you gained an experience, you know, from the Lord. Something happened to you after that experience in your adult life. Tell me about that. Tell us about that.
I must say that once in my adult life, the experience of going to college, mm-hmm. and the experience of really knowing God, mm-hmm. I also felt the pressure of having to please the people in the church.
Okay.
This is where what happened to me. This is what really made me back away. And understand, I am in no way bashing the church, because a lot of what I went through, it was self-inflicted.
Okay.
Because I went to church and developed relationships in church with and for the wrong reasons. I went to church to become a member, and it was more like a club thing. Well, we had this set over here that liked these set of people, and this set over here liked this set. So when I was in church, my focus for God was not there. But my endeavor or my longing to be accepted by people was my passion.
Now let me ask you something. So when did you get this on you that's on you now? What I mean, you know what I'm saying. I mean, can't y'all feel something on this woman? It's like you know she's packing something, and that doesn't come just from, you know, oh Lord, I love you, oh Lord, I thank you, oh Lord, I just give you praise. No, that's fire right there. That right now is a tribulation. You know, you can always tell when people done been through a little something, and when folk done been through the fire. Tell us that testimony.
Yes.
What happened to you? I think you were working for a company, and go ahead.
Getting ready to tell. before that part,
mm-hmm.
I was, and I pray that you will allow me to be honest, while in the church, I became an alcoholic. I became a crackhead. I became a heroin addict, and I was a prostitute in the church, trying to cover what I really felt on the inside. If I must say, it was a mask that I wore because I had a face for the church people. But inside me, there was this thing. And then to top it all, people of God, when I was in the church, there was a problem in my family concerning situations with my children or my child, and I worked for a lawyer. Now, I'm on public TV, so I don't really have anything to hide. I worked for a lawyer who loved me and gave me a chance of a lifetime. Nothing promiscuous about the love. He just loved me, gave me a chance to work in a law firm. My passion was wanting to be a lawyer. And since I wasn't a lawyer, I became a paralegal and a legal secretary. This man allowed me to work for him. And because of the embarrassment of what I was going through, and that thing was, I embezzled $23,000 from a man who trusted me. Because singing about learning how to trust in Jesus, telling other folk how to have faith in God and have confidence in Him, when it hit me, God help me tonight, when it hit me,
yes,
I did not have enough confidence in God to trust Him to bring me out. So I took matters in my own hand. But this is the victory of the testimony, Prophetess Bynum. When I went to court, and see, in my little town in Atlantic City, they have a thing about them where if you ever make a mistake, they don't give you a chance to get it together. They don't restore such a one.
Oh.
In the spirit of meekness. So after all of that, and I went to court, the folk were passing around the newspaper articles. They were calling folk and telling them what I had done and what I had been through. And people liked it because the devil had already said she'd never be anything.
Yes, yes, yes.
The devil had already said ain't nothing to her. She can preach, but ain't nothing to her. She sounds good, but there's nothing to her. So let me tell you about my God. When I went to court and I was standing there before the judge, and the judge looked at me, and I watched people before that going off before me. The judge was having a bad day, I suppose, and the people before me, he was carting them out. The bailiff was taking them out by the side, and he was giving them 30 days, 60 days, a year, 18 months. And when it came to me, when they called my name, and I stood there, and I was so afraid. I'd already packed my little toothbrush and already packed my little underwear because I just knew I was going off to jail. But when I stood there in the courtroom, thank you, Jesus, and the judge looked at me and he said, Mrs. Lyle, how do you want to serve your time? And I said to him, do I have a choice? He said, yes. He said, you can do weekends or you can do all the days. So when he began to read off what I had done and began to talk about my sentence, he said, 5 years suspended. God help me. Can I stand up? He said, 5 years suspended. And he kept on talking. And then he said, 30 days. And he said, you can do them on weekends. And understand this, I did not go to jail that day. I went home. He said, go home and put your affairs in order.
I went home and he said, report back here next Friday night at 6 o'clock. And you know, he said, if you don't come back, there will be a bench warrant for your arrest. Well, you got to know that that next Friday night I was there. When I went to jail, what should have been 30 days turned into 12 days. But while I was in jail and the church folk were talking, my God, while I was in jail and the church folk were judging, God let me have jailhouse rock in the Atlantic County Courthouse. If you don't believe that God can deliver, I'm here to tell you that he's a way maker. Somebody lift your hand and give God praise. I'm sorry. And I'm all shaking.
You see my life.